It's news time. Information is power. The current. The news headline. Breaking. EFCC arrest Obi Cubana for money laundering and tax fraud. Obi Cubana, a popular socialite and businessman, Obina Enyegbu, aka Obi Cubana, has been arrested by the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission for money laundering. The Anambra-born club owner, who arrived at the headquarters of the EFCC at Jabi, Abuja, at about noon on Monday, is currently being interrogated by operatives of the commission. Though allegations against the socialite were sketchy as of press time, a source disclosed that his case borders on alleged money laundering and tax fraud. The source said Obi Cubana was arrested and brought to the EFCC headquarters and is being grilled by the detectives as we speak. The EFCC spokesperson Wilson Wajaran said he has not yet to be briefed on the development. However, Obi Cubana made headlines in June when he hosted an ostentatious burial for his mother in Oba, Anambra State, in which over 200 cows were reportedly killed. The lavish display of wealth set tongues and wagging with many Nigerians wondering about his source of wealth. Several celebrities, business persons, and politicians turned out in large numbers for the funeral. And this is the news, aside that of the gubernatorial election set to hold for November 6 in Anambra State.
It's the federal government in finding a lasting solution to the crisis. The further urged IPOB not to do anything that would hinder the smooth running of the forthcoming governorship election in Anambra State, just as they asked them to cancel Shedusi Tatomoda's, saying that it has caused untold hardship on the people.
An act under in the influence of drugs, which he said must be curtailed in tackling insecurity fundamentally. He therefore suggested that government should provide jobs for the youth, while parents should take responsibility for their children upbringing. He also called for consistent engagement of stakeholders and traditional rulers as the most cardinal means to address insecurity in the state and the nation at large. And this has been the problem, according to him, about especially, even though according to him, you know, in the nation, we have always been facing challenges about implementation of laws and laws guiding the nation. Because even if Alhaji Sani Abubakar is saying the truth about the Boko Haram, you know, saying that they are being paid in dollars to carry out attacks on innocent civilians, you know, at a workshop for drugs and human trafficking for traditional leaders and religious leaders organized by the Department of Drugs, Narcotics and Human Trafficking in the state. You know, he was trying to say that he had had meetings with the Boko Haram member, and at the end of the day, what he noticed was that they were being supplied drugs, that they act under the influence of drugs, and these people are being paid, you know, in dollars, saying that the traditional rulers and religious leaders have been trying their best, you know, to voice out and look, you know, suggest ways of which there can be end to this banditry and insurgency. However, the security personnel should be blamed for not enforcing, and also the, you know, judiciary arm should be blamed for not enforcing adequately and interpreting the law for perpetrators to be punished. He applauded the traditional leaders and religious leaders for doing their own roles, because truly the lack of punishment for offenders and their sponsors is responsible for the widespread insurgency being faced today in the country. And a whole lot of leaders had actually cited this too as something that needs to be done with immediate effect, because once they have access to amnesty, you know, and they are being pampered, they feel like they can continue to perpetrate this evil act at a time that the military arm started to, you know, go after them, you know, onslaught them, burn down their food storage facilities and the likes like that. You know, these people have been reducing the manners of which they attack, because even the little ones that they are able to attack, what they demand is no money but food to feed them. So at the end of the day, they should be punished. Once these offenders are arrested, just like the Musa, one of the general commander of the operation at the Kai, actually said that it was not in their duty or their constitutional rights to prosecute, uh, to prosecute any of the offenders, that what they have to do is just to arrest these people, and they are not to even kill them. Once the person surrenders, you know, they are guided by the laws that they are prisoners, prisoners of war. So they have to just be, you know, taken, and treated just like every normal human being. So far they are surrendered, then handed over to the necessary quotas and authorities. And those are the ones that, especially the Attorney General of the Federation, and they are the one that has the right to prosecute such an offender, saying that they are not actually in the power to do that. However, the offenders, you know, when prosecuted, will know what they are supposed to, we know that they are supposed to stop that, and any other persons that want to do that will deter from such. Alhaji had said that he had had the opportunity to participate in different committees set up by several governments in the past, but discovered that the problem, according to what we've said earlier on, is the implementation of all this, implementation of all the things that they have done, and they have, that they have actually asserted or enacted that they are going to do. Explain that the government needs to provide jobs for the youth, while their parents as well should take responsibility for their children or bringing, saying that there is need for consistent engagement of stakeholders and traditional rulers as the most cardinal means to address insecurity in the state and the nation as a whole. And therefore, the security personnel and also the judiciary arm needs to pep up their responsibility with good conscience and try as much as possible to ensure that they implement all these laws, they interpret it accordingly, and they, convict these perpetrators of evil act that has been arrested. And then, this would actually serve as a deterrent to other, just like Musa had said, that these people that were arrested, that they wouldn't just be arrested, and freed like that, that regardless, they had to still face the law, even if amnesty will be granted to them, but they have to still face one or two, consequence of their actions and killing a whole lot of unarmed citizens. And also, if at all the government wants to reintegrate them back into the society, there has to be enough caution that has to be taken. They have to be very careful about this as well, because one does not really know, because they are surrendering, in thousands, and it's actually kind of suspicious. Just like the case of the Taliban in Afghanistan, it was rumored that the some of them that were integrated back, and asked to join the military forces, were those people that leaked out the ways that they operate there, and they leaked out the information of about the military formations and the likes, and that was how they were able to perpetrate and take over the Afghanistan government. Therefore, there is need to consider very well before integrating these people to the society, and then consider how they would not be they would not affect or gain access to power that will later backfire on the nation. Therefore, he has said that the government too needs to do the needful and ensure that the citizens of the country are safe and sound by convicting and prosecuting those bandits. Thanks for listening.